Subscribe the channel and click the bell icon to get updates on latest videos on this channel.
Namaskar, hello. A very warm welcome to everyone in today's episode of The Tree of Life. Last week, our guest Rita Nair shared with us such beautiful knowledge about karma, past life regression, healing, and cleansing of chakras. I have received many messages from our viewers appreciating the same. Rita, if you are watching, a big thank you to you on behalf of our viewers. I want to thank all our viewers too for the love, appreciation, encouragement, and their feedback. In case you missed the last episode or you want to watch it again, you can watch it on our Facebook page Tree of Life Show. It will soon appear on our YouTube channel also. Kindly subscribe to our Facebook page and YouTube channel for latest updates. So, moving on with the show today, let me welcome our guest this evening.
Thanks, Vivek. Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I am extremely glad that you could join us today.
Really appreciate it, Vivek. And maybe you need to lead the show.
Radhika, I have been reading your amazing write-ups on various subjects like spirituality, astrology, consciousness, mythology, etc. on various social media platforms. Your initial life was very different. You have master's in computer engineering and you have worked in IT industry, in management and leadership roles. So how this transformation happened?
See, this isn't a planned move. I was at the peak of my career in the, like when I made the shift from career to spirituality. It was in 2012. I had some, family reasons. And I didn't hesitate to leave everything behind. And, from Chennai, like after 18 years of work, I shifted to Rajahmundry. And I thought, at that time, this is what I need, a break. I would get to enjoy the life, the way I want. But, after that sort of conditioning, working in corporate environment. So as I was saying, this is not a planned move. It's just that a life happened that I had to quit the job and come to Rajahmundry, leaving everything behind. And I thought, okay, let me, see what life is all about. But, being used to certain way of living and, we have this conditioning that we should be doing something useful, productive. So it was difficult to adjust. And that was the time I was getting very restless inside, without a particular reason. I was feeling like a caged bird. And that prompted me into, looking deep into why we feel certain way, why we think certain way. And it's 8 years now. And I think I sort of figured out, how human mind works. And I understood that if everyone understands self completely, we get to understand, every person around and our relationships can be positive. And that is what I write in the post that you referred to is whatever I had discovered in my journey.
So can you share a little bit of the last 8 years of your journey?
So, coming to Rajahmundry after nearly 25 years being in Chennai is a very big shift. Because, life at Chennai, it was all about, corporate life. Working 14 to 16 hours a day studying and all that. And at Rajahmundry, like, suddenly life seems to have come to a standstill. I couldn't really connect to the mindset here. And I'm not particularly religious kind or not particularly interested in housekeeping or, you know, the regular stuff. And I didn't have people to speak to. And I always had a curious mind, you know, I keep asking why this, why that. So I tried to fit in initially to the local environment, you know, but, you know, I soon figured out this is not me. For example, you know, whenever we have these religious rituals, it's a big deal here. And I used to get very nervous, you know, because I couldn't really connect to the concept of God then. I was this confused atheist, you know, how can you believe in something that you can't see? I had that sort of a mindset. And, you know, I don't like to do anything that I don't believe in. So doing this puja, etc. is not me. And here, if you don't do that, it's like you're violating some, you know, rules. So I went through all that. I tried to fit in. Then, you know, I figured out this is not me and I decided I let go. So it was, this 8 years is more like self-assertion. Like it was like, you know, letting go parts of me that did not feel true to me. And it's about connecting to my authentic self and not being afraid about it. Yeah, if you have anything specific, you ask me because my mind is all over the place.
No, nothing specific. We just wanted to know how step by step this transformation happened. Which
I think what really helped is, you know, I was getting very depressed because I was cut off from, I like to work. In fact, I enjoyed my corporate life quite a lot. Anything I do it with full passion. So there was never a boring moment. There were always like new assignments, new initiatives. And it was like a fun ride all those 18 years. So like, you know, it was like driving a car in fifth gear and suddenly like it coming to a halt, you know. So it was difficult to get adjusted to this space. Like one of the turning points is like I was thinking, you know, I don't have like-minded people to have conversation with. Then it struck me that I have access to YouTube, you know, and I have a lot of great minds I can connect with. I would say that that is one of the turning points. I was listening to lots of people, you know, lots of people, spirituality, psychology, you know, physiology, you name it. Because I had this curious mind, I was feeding myself with, you know, various aspects of living on parenting, you know. Whatever is relevant to improve the quality of our thinking and way of living. So that was one turning point. Next turning point was, you know, coming into astrology. It was sort of mystical thing, which I can't really explain here. It just came to me. And until then, I was reading theory, but astrology was like a technical manual to understanding the spirituality, which is like vast ocean. You know, people can get easily lost. The reason I came to astrology is to understand myself, you know. Who am I? Because like every day our moods change and depending on the relationship we are in, we our understanding of self changes. Everybody mirrors different part of us. So, you know, like the sense of self isn't really definite, but and I wanted to understand what my core essence is. So that way astrology really helped me, you know, not just to understand, you know, who I am, what my essence is, but also like how human mind works, you know, how this, you know, Kala Chakra or Wheel of Time works. You know, what is this concept of universal mind? You know, when we say Krishna, actually Krishna represents universal mind. So astrology is sort of was like window to that world. You know, I understood the concept of God. Like I could relate to life much better because of astrology. And as I was writing various articles, my understanding of life improved. and along with that, the sense of peace, harmony, you know, everything was coming back. You know, whatever I was feeling, I was lacking. I realized it was because I was disconnected to parts of me. And, you know, like I was able to connect dots better, which made it easier, you know, for me to find parts of me. And also, like, the relationships have improved a lot. Earlier, like, we, our thinking will be surface level. Like, we think others think like us, you know. So we judge their reactions based on our level of thinking. But because of astrology, like, you know, I could connect to their essence, you know, why they're saying what they're saying. So I wouldn't really jump to conclusions. You know, there's a lot more bandwidth. And so it's like many people started telling me or telling as though, you know, you came inside my mind and, you know, you're reading everything. That's because astrology gives you that perspective, holistic perspective, that helps us understand everybody in a more, you know, empathetic way rather than from a judgment point of view.
Yeah, I can relate to you. Before we move to the next topic of the evening, there are some messages for you. So some people sending messages, and I would just put on the screen so that you can respond to them.
Ravi. Okay. He's my classmate. Amit. My guru. Vivi, she's my classmate. We call her Mona Lisa.
And this.
Hey Rita, my soul sister. Hi Omsi. Hi Shoma. So I have this soul tribe on Facebook. Rita, Shoma, Catherine, Soria, so many.
Thanks, Shoma. All the messages for you.
Hi Balaji. Hey Ma. She's, you know, we worked together. She was my team member in EDS. We got in touch again. Thanks, Garif. Hi Seda. She's my classmate.
Yeah, there are many messages. I'm losing the track.
Actually, I shared this meeting invite, and when people were talking about it, I was getting nervous because I'm not really, you know. Hey, hi, Muthu. Catherine, we chat every day.
This is
Praveena, my cousin. Hi, Praveena.
So, I have selected a few interesting topics from your write-ups, and it will be great if we can talk about those. In case you want to talk about something else, we can divert, but there are some topics which I have shortlisted. I read you were talking about human beingness.
Yeah.
So, it's very interesting, and I want to know more about it. I'm sure our viewers would also like to know about it.
Yeah, like for me, the unique thing about being born as a human is the possibility of our consciousness, you know, evolving. You know, we don't have to be in a certain way. But, you know, until we experience certain setbacks or we are put in some pressure situations, we tend to get locked in certain way of being. And I think the unique gift we humans have is this capability to imagine, visualize higher possibilities. And how each of us are using that capability, you know, this capability to imagine a higher possibility, that differentiates one person to another person. Let's say that if I'm in lower states of consciousness, which means that, you know, I'll be dominated by this fear, anger, anxiety, apathy, or whatever. In which case, you know, this can be because of the preconditioning, which can be, you know, from previous births or childhood trauma or something serious that happened in my life. And especially any negative scenarios, we have that post-traumatic disorder, right? We can get locked. But that is where, I mean, these are like, you know, interventions, we can call them as divine interventions to push us to be more than what we are. Because our natural state is to be joyful and harmonious. I think that is something we all need to really understand. You know, we think that spirituality says that we need to be detached from life. You know, life is like a big struggle. That is total nonsense. Human beingness is about experiencing the bliss, harmony, peace. And anything that is taking us away from that state is like a homework for us. You know, we need to figure out. And we tend to question only when we go through dark periods of life. For example, when I was in corporate world, you know, things were going so well. I mean, until I quit my job, life was like one big jolly ride. I never had to pause. You know, I got the seat in Anna University, then through campus interview, I got job, and, you know, like life went on in a very easy manner. It's only when I quit job and I was put in some situations where I couldn't express my energy, that is where I was pushed to look within. So likewise, for some people, it's death of near one, or, you know, failure of a relationship. So these are the opportunities for us. Actually, I would say that darkness is a blessing. You know, we should allow ourselves to experience that pain and question ourselves why we are feeling that pain, and, you know, give ourselves that quiet time instead of distracting ourselves with, you know, like today we distract ourselves with, you know, social media or music or books. I mean, all that is fine. But I think that quiet time itself is extremely important, that brings us to the balanced state.